Hi everyone and welcome to For The Craft. This video is brought to you by World of Warships, who requested me to make a diorama of the famous battleship Yamato. In order to create this diorama, I used two D'Agostini models at 1 to 1250 scale. I started this diorama by creating the wreck. I had to cut and convert the first model ship. This particular model has a metal lower hull and plastic upper parts, so it was quite challenging to convert it, but with the assistance of a hacksaw and my Dremel power tool, everything worked fine at the end. I didn't want any air to be trapped inside the wreck, so I filled the two pieces with liquid silicone. Then I started creating the inner levels of the ship with styrene. I also used thin wire to create the pipes and the wiring that would stick out from the pieces of the wreck. So this is the wreck after I primed it. But before I get too far into the video, I would like to say a few words for our sponsor, World of Warships. World of Warships is a free-to-play PC game enjoyed by millions of players worldwide. The game has new content releases each month, whether it is new ships, in-game nations, cosmetics, or even ship classes, you can always count on enjoying fresh gameplay experiences. You can play in more than 40 unique maps with dynamic weather, all of which have been updated with stunning new water effects and textures. You have multiple ship classes to choose from quick and devastating destroyers, do-it-all cruisers, sneaky submarines, aircraft carriers, and my absolute favorite, big and powerful battleships. And did I mention that the game is also available on consoles? So download World of Warships right now using the first link in the description and make sure to use the code WARSHIPS during registration for exclusive in-game rewards. Thanks again to World of Warships for sponsoring this video and don't forget to use the link and the code in the description to get started. This is how legends are made. Let's continue now with the project. Then I used air-dried clay in order to make the sea bottom. And whilst the clay was still soft, I pressed inside it the pieces of the wreck. When the clay was dry, I used this acrylic material to create the rust and corrosion on the surface of the wreck. Then I painted the wreck with brown, orange and grey colors. The next stage was to make the sea floor with a mixture of natural sand and PVA glue. In the real wreck, the pieces of the ship are almost crossed to each other, but here I had to put them a little differently to better fit my diorama and for display purposes. Also in the actual wreck, there are a lot of debris scattered around the two pieces of the ship, so I also placed various debris around the wreck. When all the materials dried, this was the final result for the diorama of the wreck. Then I started working on the ship. This is a very nice model, but it doesn't have the correct coloring on the superstructure of the ship. The actual ship, the actual Yamato ship, was painted with a lighter gray color, so I decided to paint again with the correct color the deck, the guns, and the superstructure of the ship. Once I finished painting the ship, I used a thin wire to hang the ship so that I could place it in the correct position inside the resin. I made a mold from plexiglass, and after I sealed it with silicone, I proceeded to the resin pouring. After 72 hours, the resin was hard enough, so I could remove it from the mold and proceed to make the sea surface. In order to make the waves created by the movement of the vessel, as well as the waves of the sea, I used an acrylic water textured gel. As soon as the first layers of the water textured gel were dry, I used a mixture of these two acrylic materials to make the sea foam on the waves and around the ship. Then, with a very fine brush, I started painting the details of the waves and the very small ripples and streaks of the sea surface. At this stage, and before proceeding to even more delicate work, I decided to stabilize my diorama on a base. So I made a wooden base, which I painted black, and then glued my diorama onto it. Once I stabilized my diorama on its base, I glued the guns, and with very thin thread and wire, I started creating the rigging of the ship. If you think putting ropes on a model ship is a challenging job, imagine having to do this on a ship in 1 to 1250 scale. At the final stages of this project, I 3D printed a nameplate and some very small aircrafts. I used a very fine brush and a toothpick to paint the aircrafts with acrylic colors. I placed the aircrafts on the ship's deck. I painted and glued the nameplate on the wooden base, and my diorama was finished. So this is the Yamato before and after diorama. I hope that you like it. Personally, I love this piece, and I hope that you enjoyed watching how I made it. Many thanks again to World of Warships for sponsoring this video. This is a fantastic game with the perfect balance of action and strategic gameplay. So don't forget to use the link and the code WARSHIPS in the video description to get exclusive rewards, including credits, premium account time, and a free ship after you complete 15 battles. As you know, I always love to hear from you, so please leave me your comment below. Tell me your opinion, what you like about this project, if you think I could have made something better, or what you would like me to do next. I would like to also thank all the supporters of this channel. You guys are all awesome. Many thanks for watching and see you again next time. Goodbye.